His full name was Raphael Sanzio da Urbino. But like Madonna and Prince, everyone just knows him as Raphael. Raphael is among the most famous artists of the Renaissance period. But how much do we really even know about him? Here are five things you may not have known about this Renaissance master.
Number one. He was never really a struggling artist. Raphael's prodigious talent was evident from a very early age. He began his artistic career at just 11 years old when he took over his father's workshop upon his death. Throughout his early adulthood, Raphael enjoyed courtly life, making a cushy living working as a court painter for Federico da Montefeltro, the Duke of Urbino, the town in which Raphael was born. He borrowed some of his early style from none other than Leonardo da Vinci. Raphael was heavily influenced by da Vinci's deft hand, which is especially evident in his early portraiture. Number 3. Raphael and Michelangelo were major rivals. Raphael was painting the frescoes on the walls and ceiling of the Pope's private library at the same time that Michelangelo was working on the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel. One day, Raphael and a buddy secretly snuck into the Sistine Chapel to check out Michelangelo's progress. Michelangelo later accused Raphael of plagiarism and said, "Everything he knew about art he got from me." Major drama. Number 4. He was also an architect. When Pope Julius lost his official architect, he named Raphael as his successor. Raphael immediately rose to the occasion, designing several churches and palaces in Rome, including a part of St. Peter's Basilica. Number 5. He allegedly died from too much sex. According to Giorgio Vasari, the Renaissance Age art historian, Raphael fell ill with a fever immediately following a night of passion with his lover Margherita Lutti. I guess if you have to die, that's a pretty good way to go.
Thank you so much for watching, everybody, and make sure to visit sardel.com, like this video, and subscribe to our YouTube channel if you'd like to see more of the fun, exciting, and slightly scandalous history of art. Oops. What was my line?